The future is now. It's time for Fame 15. Tonight, we have conversations with creative couples, Mushiya and Lou of the Damn Salon. Find out how they met and their joy working together as a creative couple. Actress and storyteller, Sheri Mann Stewart and Barry Stewart Mann. They tell us the importance of spending time as a creative family. And the young married acoustic duo, Shanae Marie and Zeno, known as Shay-Z. Plus, the cast goes head-to-head in a final trivia round of My Favorite Game Show. It's time for Fame 15.
Well, welcome to Fame 15. My name is Quincy Bonds. I'm one of the super hosts among this crew of talented individuals. I miss y'all, man. We don't see each other enough.
No.
I do. When we're not on set,
we
could go to the club and get turned up or something.
No, we too busy for all that.
See how they do me? Well, I miss y'all, man. Your conversation. Well, what's going on? Mimi Johnson.
You already know. The set of Fame 15, myfame15.com, is keeping me really busy.
Okay.
And then other projects that I'm doing as well, mimijohnson.net. But I love hanging out with my Fame 15 family.
She can't help it.
Doing JP? It big. JP?
No. JP? I know we're both light-skinned, but...
I thought y'all were brothers.
You go.
I've been in the studio, man, recording, making music, working on a few sets, trying to keep my face in front of the camera. So
I'm trying to tell these guys you spit, JP. Y'all don't have to believe it.
Listen, when they hear me, they're not gonna believe this light skin. Man, you could do. I'm not killing anybody. You know, I'm not putting nobody in the trunk. So
you know, what do you got going on, dude?
Y'all see me? I had to get my favorite design in. Look at that.
Latex.
Yes, that icaninc.com, baby.
Okay.
All right, Andy.
I'm just trying to survive this set, y'all.
I hear you.
That's it. Right?
Get it.
What are you trying to say? Is that a...
Well, listen, that's okay. Ladies and gentlemen, as you see, we get real hot and heavy in the set. Stay tuned. Don't go nowhere. Make sure you come back, because when you do, we've got creative couples in the building. They're going to tell us how to stay in love, how to have success, money, and business, and make it all work. But before we do that, our favorite subject. Everybody here loves to talk. A little bit of arguing going on. We got That's What We Think. And we're going to talk about relationships, and it is going to get juicy. So don't go nowhere, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back with Fame 15.
Come explore a new beginning at Savoy Couture Hair Salon, where we specialize in hair coloring, cuts, weaves, and precision styling. Our mission is to provide our guests with a classy, chic style. We are your premier location for all of your needs within the Atlanta metro area. Many of our guests' concerns are that they cannot find a salon that provides them with a variety of style and maintain the health of their hair. Here at Savoy Couture Hair Salon, you get the best of both worlds. Come visit us, and you won't be disappointed.
ATLDemoReels.com. We produce high-quality, low-cost web videos, dynamic and affordable. Our signature demo reels are designed exclusively for your company's products and services. Whether it's an in-studio production shoot or on-location shoot, we provide web and TV commercial advertisements for your company's products and services. Broadcast video quality at a fraction of the cost. Production packages are available now online at ATLDemoReels.com.
The future is now. It's time for your Fame 15.
Oh, hello everyone. This is your good friend Clarkston.
Just to let you know, Clarkston, me, I will be giving you a personal tour of Fame 15 and how we do things around here. You will see more of the host and the crew and me all up in the camera. So stay tuned.
Welcome back to Fame 15. Like I said, thank you for joining us. It's about to get heavy. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to talk about That's What We Think. And what we're basically covering is relationships. Whoa. So what I'd like to know from my co-host, tell me this. Who should pay for a first date? Dalton, what you think?
I would pay for a first date.
Wow.
I send flowers and I give gifts to my male friends and I get the bill.
The first date?
Because I might ask. Because usually I'm the one that's like, come on, let's go on a date.
Oh,
I'm
you're not, the aggressor.
I'm always the chooser.
The first date.
She's a boss.
I think on the first date.
If you invite me out to the date.
I'm not about to invite you out.
Oh, see, that's why they make us ask.
That's the problem.
That's why they make us
that's
ask.
That's the problem.
They wait.
Yeah, because, you know, it's not about who pays for the first date. It's more about if I invite you somewhere, then I want to take care of you. I want to treat you. I want to show you a good time. So if I'm sitting home doing nothing, you're like, hey, you want to go to the movies? Don't look for my wallet when we get to the counter.
If I call you and say, Jay, I'm going to take you out, you expect me to pay for it?
What? Yeah,
you said you're going to take it out?
All I'm bringing is my ID.
I'm going to take you out and let you
pay. That's it. Dalton.
Oh, because he's right. You are. Dalton.
I think it's okay.
Go ahead, Dalton. Where you came, bro?
Here's my thing. And being 100% honest, I think that the first time you go out with a girl, any time, that the guy should pay. I mean, and that's just how I look at it. Now, obviously, everybody's financial situation and stuff is different. Mm-hmm. So if y'all come to agreement after you've been dating a little while, and then y'all want to split it, or she takes you out, or wants to send flowers or whatever, I think that that's okay.
Hey,
and y'all got to be in the same place about it. It's just that both people in that relationship got to be on the same page.
Mm-hmm. I mean, being spontaneous and just saying, hey, Quincy, you want to go out? Cool, I got you on a meal. You're going to end up bringing me chicken all the time anyway. Wow. Watch.
Yeah, so it's an investment. She's like, she's getting that return.
It's all investment, though. It's all investment.
If you treat, do you expect something in relationships? Do we treat our significant just to get something back?
Yeah, it's a balance. I think it's a balance.
But is it expected balance?
Yeah. It's all expected balance.
Well, I believe that there should be a balance. However, you should do things out the kindness of your heart. Right. If you're always looking for a response, then you have a bar set. And if they respond what you're not expecting, then that's going to cause some internal problems.
Tisa.
You know what I'm saying?
My goodness,
ain't nobody got time for that. If I'm going to pay, if I'm going to kick a leg up, if I'm going to
do anything. Oh, legs are going up. Okay, I didn't know about that. Keep talking.
This is a family show.
Somebody got a pen.
No legs up.
I mean, I could kick my leg up now. I could do what I do with my leg right now.
But you expected me to rub that big toe in that leg go up.
That's my motion. That's motion on those knees.
Oh, that you wanna? Oh.
I'm just asking.
Look, let me change directions here, just a little bit.
Okay.
Just a little bit.
All right.
Let's talk about, you know, this show is about the independent artists and stuff.
Yeah.
Well, if you date another independent artist, or if you have a lot going on yourself, it's really hard to devote time to a relationship.
Mm-hmm.
So let's talk a little bit about, like, how do you find that balance? How do you make sure you give time to that?
I always thought dating somebody in the industry would almost be more helpful to the relationship because they can understand your schedule, what you're doing. But, you know, being in the industry a little longer than, you know, just starting, I've realized opposites attract. And if I'm on tour out doing my thing, I'd rather have her at home organizing the house, cooking, cleaning, doing whatever. Or vice versa. I'm getting a check. Okay. Now if you doing your thing, I cook and clean too, baby.
You better clean that thing up. Well, you better clean that thing.
You know, I used to agree, JP. I gotta say, man, honestly, I've tried to date the 9-to-5 person. And when you have to get up early in the morning, you know what it's like. You need your rest.
Right.
And if I'm up late and she has to get up early, it's like the synergy's not there. Our schedules never match up. And it's not like anybody's a bad person.
It's 24 hours in a day, boo. That's an excuse. 24 hours in a day.
Hey, well, tell them that. Because I think
just angry about every time.
Give
us a salon.
I ain't cleaning nothing. I will stab you.
Let me just say that as a single woman in the entertainment industry, doing just about everything from film to theater to television to performing with my live band. And also as a producer and a director as well. The one thing is balance. So okay. I know that when God gives me my significant other, we gotta balance that. I know that I'm not gonna be able to work 16 hours a day and then relationship, but right now I have that kind of time. Right. So I think it's all in balance, even with children. And some of us have, small children that are here on Fame 15.
Right.
You have to balance that as well.
So with that said, as you see, ladies and gentlemen, it is about balance.
Yeah.
It's about timing. It's about structure. And coming right back, we got a creative couple. They're going to come sit down and join us. And they're actually going to tell us all these questions, how to do it, how to make it happen, how to stay successful, how to make money, how to keep a family together, how not to stab nobody, how to learn to cook and clean, and how to love.
I'm the angry black woman. I got
it. Oh, don't hit me. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with more Fame 15.
Thank you for coming out to our auditions to find the faces of Fame 15. We had so many people to choose from. It was actually unbelievable. But we did finally narrow it down to 6 very special people. And we'll be telling you about those people coming up real soon. But we just want to tell you thank you so much for coming out to help us launch Fame 15.
What we doing, you know? What's popping, man?
Right now, we got the Fame 15 photo shoot going on. This is a little behind-the-scenes special thing brought just for you.
Yeah, y'all get to see Mark Squirrel Productions, the studio. Get to see the photographer, C. Reese, working.
World-renowned photographer.
You're watching Fame 15. Fame 15.
Is gonna be crazy world. We want y'all to look forward to it. We got a lot of wonderful hosts, a lot of wonderful people, beautiful women, nice looking guys like myself and my homie. It's gonna be a crazy season. And listen, you're dealing with some regulars, like,
right?
You know, we do this. We
look at that,
young, active, and attractive.
Look at that, young, active, and attractive. YAA.
Yeah.
Square Studios, Fame 15, the hottest new show you will experience
over the
in 2014.
Area. Soon to take over the world. Check us out.
This is Lou and Mushiya from the Damn Salon.
And the future is now. We are on Fame 15.
Coming up. We have conversations with entrepreneurs, Mushiya and Lou of the Damn Salon. ATLDemoReels.com. We produce high quality, low cost web videos for your company's products and services. Broadcast video quality at a fraction of the cost. ATLDemoReels.com, your online video production resource. Fame 15 is a pre-recorded variety talk show produced in Atlanta at Mark Squared Studios.
Welcome to Mark Squared Studios, where we offer great prices and outstanding accommodations in one convenient location.
Hot, hot studio. Make sure you do that.
Fashion photographers and filmmakers now have an ideal space for professional in-studio shoots. So photographers and filmmakers, sign up now and unbox your Mark Squared membership today. Welcome to Mark Squared Studios.
Hey, what's up, you guys? It's your girl, Tierra Hooks from Fame 15. And today we are at the Damn Salon with the founders, Miss Mushiya and Lou. So how are you guys today?
Wonderful, we're doing wonderful.
Great. Good, good, good. So tell me, like, what made you guys want to come up with that name? Because it's such an interesting name. Like, when I see that, especially when I was driving by, because my brother like gets his hair cut next door, and I remember driving by and being like, "What is that? The damn salon? Like what?"
Well, before we get to the name, tell them what it is first.
Yeah.
Like, because people at home, we know what you do and who you are, but people at home don't. So maybe take a couple minutes to just tell us what it is, where we're at, and where you guys kind of come from and stuff.
Okay. Fine. We're at the damn salon. We're at the damn salon. We actually do high fashion natural hair. I have personally been doing hair for a very long time, maybe 17, 18 years. I keep changing the number of years like every second, so later on I might say 19. But we've been here in Atlanta for about 8 years, and we actually tour as well. I created a style that we named City Twist, Urban Twist, and Micro City Twist. We have a variety of styles that we actually innovated. So people come exclusively to us, and they travel to us from various different cities and so forth to receive this style, basically. And I'm not sure if I answered your question, but did I?
kind of.
Back to the simple question. Where did you guys get the name?
The name? You want to do it?
I think that's...
I'm going to end up talking too much.
No.
Okay, fine. So the name basically is, you know, everything we touch, everything we do, we're very edgy, you know? Mm-hmm. All of our sayings, all of our taglines or whatever, everything we touch, we just do it such that anybody will just say, damn. It's done with edginess, it's done with class, it's done with just a lot of passion, you know?
Mm-hmm. So it's a real modest name.
I mean,
you're just telling it how it is, right? It's good.
That's it.
Okay, so what kind of, I know you said you guys make a lot of different types of twists. What kind of twists are you wearing now for people?
I'm actually wearing an urban twist.
Okay.
And the urban twist, you know, all of our styles, we custom contour them and custom layer them to the face and bone structure of the person. Hmm. My hair is actually natural, but I added some hair. Mm-hmm. So anybody can really achieve this style. It's a great protective style, especially these days when a lot of black women are going natural and really don't know what to do or how to take care of their natural hair. Mm-hmm. This is where the damn salon comes in. So you know where to find us.
So talk a little bit about, we've got, you're into fashion, mm-hmm. hair. Where do you come in, Lou?
Oh, I come in pretty much, I handle a lot of the business aspect in terms of, for example, right now in my business season, actually, I do the taxes. I handle a lot of the marketing and entertainment as well, and pretty much the daily activities of the damn salon. So I manage, you know, overall the whole operation of the damn salon.
And going off of that, I know you guys started, you personally started off in like the garage of your mom's house and all that stuff. I know that you learned from your mom and stuff. So marketing must be a really big deal, because I know you guys have several locations. So like, what did you guys do to kind of get the name out there and get more clients to come in?
Well, nowadays, social media is one big advantage. Yeah. You know, we have a variety of ways to actually advertise the damn salon. Our biggest advertisement is actually words of mouth, mm-hmm. believe it or not, because people, the style that we do is so unique. Once pretty much any of our clients who walks out, and they are walking advertisement for us, and, you know, the product is good and people love it.
Yeah, and I know you guys both have clearly accents. So where are you guys originally from? Because I know you speak French too. So where are you guys from?
I was born in Haiti, but really? I was raised, you know, in Miami, Florida, and also New Jersey.
Cool.
And I migrated here about eight years ago.
And you?
Myself, I'm from Congo. So I was born in Congo, went to school in Zimbabwe. Then somehow made it to Missouri, where my father did his doctorate. And then I went to school in Montreal and then found my way to New Jersey. Actually, he stole me from Montreal.
Oh. Is that what happened?
That's exactly what happened. He stole me and, you know, slowly snuck me
in
his
house. Look at his face. He's like, I don't know if I stole her or if she just
That's exactly how it happened. That's exactly how it happened. Okay?
That's up for debate.
No, no, no. There's no debate. Like, thus, even though I have a terrible memory, I have a memory impairment, I do remember he stole me, okay?
Well, now listen, your background, you also do music too, right?
Absolutely.
And you've worked with some of the producers from Akon. You've got a big background in music. So how does that play into the damn salon and what you guys do here?
When you go to the website, pretty much with the damn salon, we try to keep a lot of stuff in-house because we got so many talents between, you know, she and I, and pretty much people inside the team. So we got so many talents. So we do a lot of stuff in-house. For example, when you go to the Damn Salon website, all of the music that you hear is produced by me, and the vocals pretty much is her on the songs.
We use them for our fashion shows as well, too.
Exactly.
On the runway, like we always play our songs.
So all these different little pieces really go into creating a brand.
Yes.
And very much so in this circumstance. Even down to the wine that we're drinking, which she won't tell us what it is because this is what she serves customers when they come in. But that's all part of your marketing plan and part of your brand. So talk a little bit about how you've gone about creating that successful brand and how it's impacted your business.
She's a genius behind it.
Quickly, the short version.
Oh my gosh, you're saying I'm long-winded? He just said I'm long-winded. Okay, fine. Short version, the brand, I guess we infiltrate everything that we kind of grew up with in our culture. We grew up with service. We grew up with food. We grew up with cuisine. We grew up with like just servicing the people that are around you, you know? So one thing that really stands out in the Damn Salon is the customer service that we give people. We feed them while they do their hair and so forth. And so just also with regards to the brand.
We're going to have to hear the rest of that right after we come back. Okay. I know she's a little long-winded, but we're going to get some more of it and about how they're a couple. When we come back, more Fame 15.
You're watching Fame 15.
It's your girl, Miss Nika. I'm on the mic. I'm doing what I want to do because this is fun. Just want to let y'all know we about to get started. Facebook us, tweet us. I'm saying Instagram, follow us, Fame 15.
She still talking?
It's your girl, Miss Nika.
Would you like to be a special guest on our show or just hang out with us on set in the studio? We have extra seats just for you. If you're 15 years of age or older, live in the Metro Atlanta area, and happen to be a creative, we'd love to have you as a guest on Fame 15. Our show is dedicated to creatives from film, arts, music, and entrepreneurs. Unbox your creativity and sign up now at myfame15.com.
So finish telling us about your brand.
So basically the brand is just, it's about natural hair, it's about high fashion, it's about having balls, it's about having confidence, it's about a lot of things that, a lot of things women just wish they could be but are too afraid to be. We are it. And we give women, you know, the ability to just be who they are, you know, no holds bar. Is that what people say in America?
Yeah.
Okay. We've been stalking you a little bit. I looked up some YouTube videos before I came, and I noticed you mentioned some stuff about girls who press their hair. So why, I know that you guys just specialize in natural hair. Why do you guys like focus on that instead of doing like a wide range of hair?
It's not even about a wide range of hair. It's more about healthy hair. And pressing hair is not healthy for the hair, so we don't do it. We refuse to do it. I'm against fellas who do it. And I tell girls all the time, you know, don't press your hair. If you're going to go natural, pressing your hair changes and alters your hair texture. So we stand by it by also not doing it in our salon.
But would you say that for every hair?
Yours too.
Because she's talking to you.
Because I know I'm.
I don't press mine. See, we get along.
Just me personally.
You've messed up.
Just me personally. I know that every hair type is different. We all know that. Whether it's natural or straight, whatever. Some people, if you straighten their hair once, their curl pattern can get ruined completely, just once. Some people, you can straighten 1,000 times and the hair still springs right back up to curls. So do you think that is the case for every single hair type?
It's the case for every single hair type.
Okay.
For every single hair type, it's going to. It might take 99 times. Mm-hmm. It might take 1.5 times, but at what point would you know what it's going to take? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Either way, it's not good for your hair texture. I'm against it. And also, I'm against it for several reasons. Black women have this tendency to believe that they're better and they're more beautiful with straight hair.
You think so?
Absolutely.
What?
So a lot of black women and a lot of people generally think that beauty comes in a package of straight hair. You follow what I'm saying? That's not a secret.
Mm-hmm.
You wouldn't agree with that?
Well, I have some, you know, some disagreements with okay. some natural hair people because they think that because we press our hair and stuff like that, that we're like a fake now or we're putting on a type of appearance. But I, in my opinion, I think you can say that for every girl. Girls who put on nail polish, that's not, you weren't born with nail polish.
Fake. I don't think that you're being fake at all.
Okay.
You know? But the mass population of women do believe that you need straight hair to be beautiful, or you need straight hair to work in corporate America. And I always tell women that's very, very untrue.
Yeah.
You follow what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So if you do it because you like the look, you like the style, fine, whatever. Mm-hmm. I just won't be the one to do it for you.
Yeah.
All right, so let's transition a little bit. The theme of this whole show is creative couples, and you guys are a couple. So let's talk a little bit about that. How is that working together all the time, being together all the time? I mean, we get tired of each other after a couple hours.
Yeah.
You live together, work together, be together. Talk a little bit about that.
I mean, for us is, we actually were friends before anything. So it actually helps because, I mean, we've been together for so long and, you know, being friend first, and we actually enjoy each other's company. So for other people, it may be hard. I mean, we have disagreements. We both have strong opinions. She probably wins most of them.
Untrue. That's so not wisely. True.
But, yeah, we enjoy being around each other. And I think together we you know, we've accomplished so much. And we have the best creative ideas when we actually work together. So it always works in our favor.
So what's something that you guys like to do on your downtime, like when you're not working? What's something you guys always do? Do you have like a movie night or something like that?
We take trips out of state.
Really?
Yeah, nice. we vacation a lot.
That's always nice. Yeah. What's your like favorite place that you guys can both remember?
Right now I'm big on Haiti.
Haiti?
That's fair. That's kind of cheating. Yeah.
Did you have fun?
Yeah,
I had fun in Haiti. We're going back right now.
Yeah, like, yeah, we got a trip coming up soon. So we actually have a project that we're doing in Haiti as well. So, you know, right now we're actually in the process of building a small resort, like a villa in Haiti. So that takes us there a lot. And, yeah, that's one of our favorite places right now. We're big on Haiti.
Awesome.
So what's, like, a short version of, like, how you guys met? Like, where did you guys meet?
We met through a mutual friend. And actually...
Maybe what was your alcohol involved? Like what happened?
He's about to tell a whole bunch of lies.
Okay.
Yeah, you better think about this before you say.
We're gonna have a Mr. and Mrs. version.
Well, basically, she was talking to one of my friends.
Oh,
on the
phone.
No,
Mr. Stewart, your girl.
No, not like that. Not like that. Okay, she was talking on the phone.
Okay.
Which, a mutual friend. Yes, a mutual friend.
Okay.
And.
I
happened to hear her voice, and she sounded very, very charming on the phone, very sexy. So, and I said, "Who was that?" And then he passed me the phone, and then we started talking. And from that point on, she just nothing.
Okay, and your version?
My version. The same thing happened at the beginning, but then after we first met. You know, he lived in Jersey, I lived in Montreal, and slowly but surely he moved me in without me realizing.
She came in for a couple of days, and next thing I know.
And then showed up with a U-Haul, right? Oh, yes. Right in the front yard. I know what you're talking about.
I'm with you. Okay.
So you guys obviously work really well as a couple. And you talked about you have fights and stuff like everybody does. But especially in this industry, whether it's entertainment or fashion or music or whatever it is, people always say it's hard to date within the industry. You know, get somebody outside of the industry that has a regular schedule that complements you. So what would you guys say to somebody like that? It's like, I'm not going to date another actor if I'm an actor because it's too difficult.
I would say that this works. This works because we're always on the same train of thought. And having that support of somebody who understands the business is so, 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 so important. You know, it keeps you grounded. I can always go to him for advice. He can come to me for advice. Together, we sit and we come up with creative ideas. I think our best ideas actually come on the road when we take long road trips and we just drive and we just talk and think about it, you know? And like a lot of times people have problems when they're in different businesses or in different industries because they can't understand the other person's lifestyle. He understands my lifestyle. I understand his. We have a similar lifestyle.
So if you guys each had to pick one thing, what do you think has been the most important thing to your success?
Strange. We have no answer. we were to pick one thing, what's been the most important thing to our success? I believe it's each other's support. And I believe it's our friendship, because just like he was saying earlier, you know, we'll fight, we'll go through stuff, but we're friends. So even when we go through stuff, I still want to come to him and say, oh, by the way, listen, I have this great idea. Da, 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 da. I know we're not talking right now.
Right. Yeah.
But let me just run this by you, you know?
Yeah.
Or let's go out or whatever, you know? So I think we just support each other. Like, he always has me. And at the end of the day, I always have him. So it's a big deal.
And I know you guys do like a lot of tours and stuff. So do you guys have any tours that are like coming up that we can look forward to?
Absolutely. We have a tour coming up in March. We're doing New York, D.C., Houston. And that's going to be from March 12th, I believe, to March 24th.
Okay. Well, it's been such a pleasure talking to you guys. We are inspired ourselves. I will try not to fight with him as much.
We'll try to be a better creative couple.
Yeah. You know. But yeah, it was very, very nice talking to you guys, and we look forward to seeing even more locations of the Damn Salon.
All right, guys. Unfortunately, that is all the time that we have. Thank you guys so much for having us. I propose a little toast with this branded wine of yours.
This is to the thousands of locations of the Damn Salon that are going to open soon.
And to creative couples everywhere.
Yay. Cheers.
You're watching Fame 15. Coming up, the cast goes head-to-head in a final trivia round of My Favorite Game Show. Fame 15 is a pre-recorded variety talk show produced in Atlanta at Mark Squared Studios.
So the name Tomatillos comes from the signature ingredient in our salsa verde, which is the tomatillo, fresh tomatillos, a green tomato. Tomatillos is somewhat new to East Atlanta Village. It's right in the heart of the village in what used to be the Wachovia Bank building, and what I understand used to be the original post office in the village. We were happy to finally be able to purchase this old bank building and rehab it into tomatillos. I think when you come in the front door, you'll experience what our passion is all about for the concept of fresh burritos. It's a very simple concept. We have wonderful margaritas, salads, chicken crack empanadas, fresh chips and salsa. Everything's made fresh daily, and I think you'll realize that when you walk through the doors and smell the aroma for the first time. We've been in business now for 2 years and hope to be here a lot longer. You can find us online at tomatillos-atlanta.com, or if you're in the wonderful neighborhood of East Atlanta Village, 1242 Glenwood Avenue. And we look forward to seeing you here and hope that you have a wonderful experience.
And hello once again, everyone. This is your good friend, Clarkston. I would like to say thank you for watching the host and the crew and the show Fame 15. A little bit more about me, I love to dance. And when I dance completely bare.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for another exciting episode of My Favorite Game Show.
Welcome to Fame 15's My Favorite Game Show. I'm Ryan Seamith. Today's favorite game is Famous Feud. Your host, Miss Mimi Johnson.net.
Welcome to Famous Feud. Today we have some of the most favorite and fabulous celebrities ever. Over here, we have On the Up and Up, and on my other side, we have the unclaimed celebrities. Heading the On the Up and Ups is Judge Joe Mathis.
How you doing, ma'am? Yes, I'm your honorable Judge Joe Mathis from the city of Detroit, by the way. I love Detroit. Detroit, stand up.
Okay, thank you very much. And we have Miss Nikki Collage.
Yes, I'm Nikki Collage, Nikki Lewinsky, Nikki the Ninja, Nikki the Harajuku Barbie. I mean, it's like, you know, I'm so young money.
Okay, thank you very much. And we have Mr. Robert DeNono.
Okay, that's Robert De Niro, okay? All right, if you tell anybody you saw me here, I'm gonna hit you in the head with a bat. My wife thinks I'm at Walmart, all right? Getting bologna and ice cream, all right? Say nothing, all right, dead.
Okay, thank you.
Dead, you'll be dead.
Thank you very much. And over here we have the unclaimed, we have the token white guy.
I'd like to give a call out to my people back home. Hey, Betty, Doris, Beatrice, my cousin Eddie.
Okay, thank you so much.
And Martin.
Excuse me, Vanna Black.
Wrong show, ma'am.
Huh? Get it done. You're done. Huh? Done.
Ma'am.
And finally, D. Jones.
It's your boy, y'all, D. Jones, R&B soul star. Check this out. If there's any doubt in your mind, you can count on me. Yeah.
Sir.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Sir.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay. Now that we know who's playing, we're going to start with the up and up. We have four answers on the board. Two strikes, and the other team gets a chance to steal. Now let's feud. Okay. Our question is, name something people hope that a house guest doesn't do in the bed. Judge?
Name something that people don't want you to do in the bed. Yeah. Well, I'm from Detroit, ma'am, so smoke crack. Smoke crack, ma'am. I don't want people coming into the house, my house, smoking crack, ma'am.
Okay, smoking crack.
I hate crack.
Yeah. Good answer.
Right. Yes, it's a good answer.
Nikki? I think that you don't want to, you know, make love to Lil Wayne. Maybe Birdman, because he got the money. You know what I'm saying? He cut that check, because I'm so young money. But you don't want to make love to Lil Wayne.
You got
make to love to Lil Wayne.
Yeah.
Sorry, Nikki.
What?
Bad answer. Mr. Robert?
I'll tell you what, all right? 2 years ago, my Aunt Lucille came. She died. All right? She died in the bed. Huh? You don't want it. You don't want anybody to die in the bed, all right? She was on the top bed. She fell off onto the floor, died right there. She was dead. She was dead. She was gone. My Lucy, it was Christmas. She was dead.
Yes. Okay. Okay. Dead in the bed. Huh? Good answer. Now, remember, you only have one more chance, and they get to steal. Okay. So, I need to know your answer.
Ma'am, put my gavel down, ma'am.
Put it down.
What? Ma'am, what's the answer?
Put my gavel down, ma'am.
What's the answer?
Don't give me the gavel, ma'am.
Don't nobody want your gavel. Huh? What's the answer?
Whoo, Lord, ma'am. I'm a changed man. You know what? Ma'am, I still feel the same way, ma'am. So I feel that you shouldn't be smoking crack in the bedroom, ma'am. I got it right the first time.
In the bathroom. Crack is whack.
It's up there.
Okay, okay. Judge Mathis, you already said that.
And I still feel the same way, ma'am.
Okay, and it's wrong, sir. And now your opponent gets to steal.
Huh? You steal? You steal for me? Nah, nobody steals.
Hello? Are you paying attention to the game? The queen has arrived. Token white man, what is your answer?
People should not eat extra fibrous bran flakes in the bed because they're grainy.
And the survey says? Sorry, unclaimed. Well, there you have it. We have on the up and up, and they have won the feud famous game show. And we'll be right back.
Join us for another exciting episode of My Favorite Game Show.
For more information, log on to myfame15.com.
You're watching Fame 15. Coming up, actress and storyteller Sheri Mann Stewart and Barry Stewart Mann. ATLDemoReels.com. Dynamic and affordable. ATLDemoReels.com. Whether it's an in-studio production shoot or on-location shoot, our signature demo reels are designed exclusively for business owners, actors, music artists, and entertainers. Production packages are available now online at ATLDemoReels.com.
your online video production resource. ATLDemoReels.com.
And now introducing the Stewart Manns, or the Mann Stewart. Hi. Nice to see you.
Pleasure to be here.
Okay. I have got to ask this question because I've been thinking about this since I've been researching you. Mann Stewart, Stewart Mann. Give it to me.
Well, when we decided to get married, between 18 and 19 years ago, we didn't think it felt right for me just to change my name suddenly to his name.
Okay.
I had my own career, I had my own life.
Yes.
I wanted to keep my name. I wanted old high school friends to be able to find me and that kind of thing. And
even before the age of Facebook, right?
Okay.
There you go.
She knew it.
Even before. So we thought of all different options. We thought about creating a brand new name for ourselves and for our couple. We thought about all the various hyphenated options, and we said, well, we don't really want to go that way. And so then we decided to each drop our middle names and take each other's last names as our middle names. So I started out Sheri Lynn Stewart.
And I was Barry Paul Mann. And with our names, it worked out fairly nicely to become Barry Stewart Mann and Sheri Mann Stewart.
That's awesome.
Man. A couple that knows compromise.
right.
No wonder, that's 19 years, you know.
Yes. Wham, bam, thank you, man.
Yeah.
And we also felt like it was a creative solution to it. And after we had come up with that idea, we found out that John Lennon and Yoko Ono had legally done the same thing.
Oh.
And so we thought we were in pretty good company.
Okay.
Promising
start then.
Yes.
Trendsetters, right.
I'm going to do that when I get married.
All right.
Thank you.
Well, I'm going to find out. I know that, I've been accused of being selfish in relationships, okay? And I know, right? Can you believe that?
No.
I have. And part of it's because of my time. It's hard to find time when you're so busy to fit dating and love and just how you guys remember that you guys are a couple and work. How you guys fit it all in to make time for each other. How does that?
Well, you're right. It is challenging, but one of the things is we structure our own time. Mm-hmm. And so we find the time to spend time together. We have two sons, and so a lot of our time together is with our sons and as a family, and we're always out doing things. So we go to events, we're politically engaged, we're engaged in the artistic communities and spiritual communities, things
and
like that.
And our sons keep us quite busy. They are 15 and 12, and we've unschooled from the beginning as well, which has been, I guess, another one of our creative life choices. But they have also chosen to become professional actors and filmmakers.
Yeah.
And so that's an even greater challenge in terms of spending time together or as a family. But it also provides some pretty good opportunities. We end up traveling together some to really interesting places and events.
Wow.
And with Barry being a storyteller, sometimes that takes us on the road to festivals. And with our unschooling, which is one form of homeschooling, we are not having to answer to someone else about the schedules, so we can consider a trip to South Georgia or Florida or France or Indonesia an educational experience for the kids as well as family
awesome.
Time.
That's fabulous.
Pleasure all together is kind of the answer. Okay, nice.
Wow.
Nice, thank you.
Well, that brings me to a question. You obviously have a very successful family. I want to know, and you mentioned you were successful before you guys were married. You established a name. You already had some things going on for yourself. So when you came together and joined forces, now, obviously everybody thinks empowerment. We can take over. You have this, I have that. We can be like Superman, Captain America, Mr. Whatever, you know. But when she gets an opportunity opposed to you, or maybe one arises for you and not her, is there any type of jealousy, tension? Now, of course, everybody goes, no, I love her. I want da da da. But, obviously, if you're dry for a minute, because we're not always all busy. How do you handle that?
Well, for one thing, we're not often up for the same role.
There you go.
So that helps.
Right.
Well, I was going to say, or even in some ways, we don't work that much in the same field, so to speak. We're both very creative. Sheri is more... as an actress and as a filmmaker and working in production and in the independent film market.
So there's no competition.
We both have done theater and both do theater. I tend to work a lot more in education, storytelling, arts integration, in that end of it.
Yes.
I'm not as deeply involved in the film industry. I'm not as good an actor on film. She's amazing on camera. She really is. No, it's just the truth.
He's
she
very
really
talented.
Is.
He yeah. Was, let's see. Every year he tends to do a major stage role. Last year he played Tevye in a production of Fiddler on the Roof. He was a guest artist in an Atlanta production of Fiddler on the Roof. The year before, he was nominated for a Susie Award for a supporting role in The Green Book over at Theatrical Outfit. So he stays busy, and he's a wonderful actor, but he's right. We don't really overlap. Stage acting has some different technique.
Yes.
Well, even with the success, is it motivating? Like, you know, if he gets all these accolations and you're like, well, my time's
you'd be like, that's my husband.
Yes, I'm good. That's
yeah.
awesome.
That's we
awesome.
Bring each other along. And
that's
let each,
it.
And
I think we know that there are plenty of other people out there that we're competing against.
So
you know, in this field, we don't need
other.
To compete against
that's
each
right.
other.
Behind
that's
every
right.
good man is an even better woman.
Can I ask you one quick final question real quick? Mm-hmm. How is it that, how do you go about with controversy? Like, can you give me, because I couldn't work with my husband. Can you give me one piece of advice making it to 20 years, almost 20 years?
Can we give you, I'm sorry,
a piece of advice.
A piece of advice.
Are you talking about personal life or career life?
Personal
or both?
And career.
Well, I would say, you know, in terms of working together creatively, I don't feel like we've had controversy. I think that when we're involved in a creative project together, and there have been a couple, we did a short film called Insanity du Jour, where we played a husband and wife in a very abusive, not physically abusive, but emotionally abusive relationship.
Okay. Yes.
So that was interesting, but it wasn't problematic. We did a stage production of Murder in the Cathedral years ago. But creatively, we're pretty fine together. I think the challenge comes sometimes when it's balancing those work, home, you know, things of where maybe one of us feels like the other one is pushing, you know, is going out and doing a career thing, and it would be great if we were home.
Right. I would say the biggest challenge is just the practical, logistical scheduling of everything.
Okay.
Many of our conversations and much of our time is spent on who's getting what boy where. Even today we came in separate cars here because I dropped our younger son at his bowling team. After this, Barry will go and pick him up and take him to his baseball team tryout, and then I'll be picking up our older son to join them so that we can watch our younger son play his basketball game this afternoon.
Wow.
Before getting them off to a party.
Is who makes more money?
No, I'm just kidding.
Our
12-year-old. All right, you guys, we're going to be right back. Barry's going to be kind enough to show a little bit of his craft with some storytelling. Here's a creative couple. You guys can do it at home, and we'll be right back with more Fame 15.
Yeah.
You're watching Fame 15. Coming up, the young married acoustic duo, Shanae Marie and Zeno, known as Shay-Z. Fame 15 is Atlanta's new variety talk show where you can expect to see interviews unboxed from local filmmakers, actors, artists, musicians, and self-made entrepreneurs. So tune in right here and be sure to check us out on myfame15.com.
You're watching Fame 15.
How you doing? This is Miss Mimi Johnson.net, the Triple Threat. We are here on the set of Fame 15. We're holding it down at Mark Squared with our photographer, C. Reese.
Fame 15.
Getting ready to bring you guys a fantastic show. So we're looking forward to January 2014.
We're here at Mark Square, Fame 15.
Hi, it's Nicole Ward here at Fame 15, just doing my photo shoot. So excited to be with the beautiful Althea. We just finished it, killing it.
I'm Maddie.
I'm Philippe.
And we are the future of Fame 15. You can find us everywhere, almost on every single social media account at MyFame15.
And go on our website to subscribe to our newsletter.
The future is now.
Welcome back to Fame 15. I'm your host, Dre P. As you know, we've been talking about creative couples, dynamics, ups and downs, which brings me to a very interesting dynamic duo, a married couple from Baltimore, Maryland. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Shay-Z. What's up, Shay-Z? Shay-Z, Dre P. I like the sound of that. So welcome to the show. Of course, I know you guys come from Baltimore, Maryland. I did some research about you guys, myself and Common. I moved here in Atlanta in 2012, but you guys visited California for about 3 months.
Yes, yes.
Tell me about your experience in California. What made you go from Baltimore to Cali? Like,
I guess I can answer that one. At the time, I was in a different band. At the time, I had my own band called Grad Day, and that was our main goal, to move out to California. So me and the other head runner of the group, we decided to move out there and set up, you know, for the band members to come out there, and they eventually never came out there.
So, oh, man.
We were kind of stuck with, you know, the rent in the house, basically the rest of the
And that California rent is steep.
You know,
right.
So.
That's why I left, so I can relate.
So that from there, so we just, it was just too much financially for us, so we decided to come to Atlanta.
Yeah, the black mecca of hip-hop,
yeah,
music,
yeah.
Everything, yeah. Black Hollywood, everything. Yeah. Now, I know that Shay, Z, how did we come up with this name? It's actually an acronym for both of your original names,
yeah.
Or?
So his stage name, my original name. So Shanae and then Zeno Moonflower is his stage name. So take the Shay, take the Z, Shay-Z.
Shay-Z, swag, okay, okay. Now, I've also did some research about you, Miss Shay. Mm-hmm. You not only sing, but you model.
I did.
You got the Tyra Banks figure going, so all right, I can see that. Now, which one did you pursue first? Did you do modeling or did you get into music first?
As long as I can remember, I wanted to pursue modeling. It's funny you said Tyra Banks, because I was obsessed with Tyra Banks, like, forever. And then I met him, and I always sang, but I always had stage fright, and he just...
Well, it looks like you put the modeling to the side to pursue the group. Let's go to a short commercial break, guys, and when we come back, we're going to see Shay-Z live on Fame 15.
Look into my eyes and tell me what you hear. If you would like to be a guest on our show, Fame 15, log on to myfame15.com. Just go to the website and put your information in. And if the producers like you, you will be on that show. They will contact you. But if the producers do not like you, they will not contact you. So you cannot get an attitude. This is your good friend, Clarkston, completely bare behind the scene.
Shay-Z live on Fame 15.
Daddy and I, here we come. We won't stop till the job is done. We take it over the world. We take it over the world. Daddy and I, here we come. Till the job is done, we take it over the world. We take it over the world. Well, Shay-Z be our name. Well, in bed, daddy, you pray. Flower power be the team. The posse vibes is what we bring. Vibe into my G-strum. Peace and love, let's spread some. With that said, I think it's about time that we can roll up. Blow it to the sky. Send your wishes to
find it, baby, we gon' go far. And I know what I promised you, a big house and a couple cars. She said we gon' save my money, we gon' spend yours. Oh, baby girl, it's forever. We taking over the world, you and me together. Trying to upgrade this cheddar to my Toretta. With my tall dreads, your big fro ain't no comforetta. Now, here we come, we won't stop till the job is done. We take it over the world, we take it over the world. Ready now, here we come, we won't stop till the job is done. We take it over the world, we take it over.
My flow big, can't do it. Flow cold like a snowstorm. My man on my arm and we ball, we set to blow. This love's for real, we ain't putting on a show. See, we all about that peace, keep that drama out of my zone. Cause it's all love, yeah, one love. We taking over, we taking over. My mind's clear, I'm so focused. I ate the chips, I'm on the show.
Chasing that drink, yeah, we go far. We go far, daddy, right and sick. Yeah, they go far, they go far. Told ya, we're taking over. Give a couple years so we can say we told ya we're taking over. We're taking over.
Thank you. My Fame 15!